commitment is to the poorest of the poor. Always. Our commitment is to the most sick. Our commitment is to those that nobody wants to live with. You know, when you talk about charity, people think, oh, it has something to do about money. But real charity, that you don't want anything back for it. It's like selfless love.
This here was underneath, to here, all the way around.
Really?
Was all, you know, you could put your whole hand under there, you know. But now it's all stuck, you know. Everything is stuck in here, is all sticking. So once it's all stuck like that, then it can start to grow in, you know. So it's really a lot better. And before it was just muscle, you know. You could see all the muscles. But then you get that granulation tissue growing. Just like, and that's what they can put a skin graft onto.
When we as a band made an idea to go to India to have a tour, I immediately volunteered. I said, yes, sure, I want to organize that, help to organize that. So I went off to India. I was first in Bombay, and I happened to stay for the first 6 months between all professional people, and I even did get the idea that there was maybe no poverty in India. Till I started to travel. And when I came in Delhi, I sat with somebody in a car and we drove over a big road, and I saw suddenly a naked body lying in the gutter. It was a younger boy, but the car just passed on. The driver just shrugged his shoulders and said, what can we do? This is India. It was actually for the first time that I saw really third world suffering coming from the affluent West. This was really a shocking picture I saw in it. It haunted me to see these faces with hunger written over it, and it was very hard to after having encountered something like that to leave the country, to just go in your comfortable airplane and fly away of it. And on that moment I felt I cannot longer live like this. When I see things like this, I have to respond. It's quite a responsibility when you find somebody on the street and who's very sick. You, the moment you pick him up, you need to take care of the person. You cannot say from, oh well, this is a difficult case, you know. This guy is not nice. He shouts at me, you know. He doesn't walk and he always does it in bed. Let's put him on the road again. No way. You know, you're committed to the person. You have to help him. I think he should, looks like cancer. It's a boy and I think he has cancer in his jaw. And so he has bandage wrapped around and he goes to the Gurdwara. But I think you should pick him up on the way back for the ashram. So what you need to take care of the homeless is a house.
Since when is he on the street?
One month on the road, eh? Does he still get the injection and the stabilizer? Okay, but we give him 12 o'clock. We really challenged with some, you know, we pick people up that have terminal cancer. We have here at present, I think, 32 tuberculosis patients in a rather serious condition. As we also are in need of good medical workers, doctors that will be involved. So it is quite a struggle to get all the examinations done. It often takes weeks on end. In that way, it would be better that we had our own clinical facilities, a good ICU, to give good care to these to these people. Like Nirmal in that bed, you kind of rescued him from Kingsway Camp Hospital. And it's absolutely like Auschwitz conditions. Rats, dogs, bathrooms absolutely destroyed.
There are patients that can't walk sometimes, and if they don't have anybody to help them or so, and they have to kind of crawl in here, you know, across the floor to get to the bathroom to use. And mostly they don't bother, you know. We find people that just end up shitting in the bed, you know, because there's too much of an ordeal to come here. So we find people that have been a week, like, in the bed, and lying in their own shit and piss and just completely filthy. And once they get to that state, nobody has come to them. The doctors, you know, go around them. They don't, you know, they'll just leave them to die, kind of, you know. So.
You know, to share your life with people like we find in the street and hospitals is enriching your life, you know. I have one guy, Shankar. He has an anger problem, you know. He can get so angry. So I told him, from, you know what is good medicine? You take care of Nirmal. Whenever somebody tells you something stupid you can get angry about, just go to Nirmal. And Nirmal, you know, with his eyes and his complete dependence on you, will be good medicine for you. Shankar is feeding him, you know, and looking and kind of laughing. So Shankar's heart softened by the crazy look in Nirmal's face, you know, because he's like a little baby. So this is like Shankar is healed.
Drink a baby down. Excuse me, too busy, oh, writing your tragedy. These mishaps, you bubble wrap when you've no idea what you're like. So let go, jump in. Oh, well, what you're waiting for? It's alright, cause there's beauty in
life is actually the best way to heal. We all need community. People are really helpful.